standard PLC, the...
Okay, so hello and welcome live from the Hannover Messe. As promised, today we are going to talk about our high-performance safety control, but first let me introduce you to my two colleagues, Martin Börs and Simon Davis.
Hi.
Hi. Martin, you are a technical expert and specialist for our control technology, and Simon is responsible for functional safety at Phoenix Contact. But let's start with a new control. Martin, what is so special about our new RFC controller?
So this is the newest member of the PLCnext Control family. It's the RFC 4072S. It's the most powerful PLC that Phoenix Contact has ever produced, and in fact it's among the highest performing PLCs you'll find on the market today. But that's not all. It also includes a functional safety controller for functional safety applications up to SIL 3 or performance level E.
Wow, okay. So such a high performance controller is certainly not that easy to develop. What were your biggest development challenges?
Well, of course, Phoenix Contact has a lot of experience with PLCnext technology, but taking such a high-performance hardware platform, putting on the openness of PLCnext technology, and then combining that with the security and reliability of a functional safety controller, that wasn't easy, but here we have it.
Okay, so safety and PLCnext. And PLCnext, you already mentioned it. For everyone who hasn't heard of it before, what is the PLCnext technology?
So PLCnext technology we consider to be like an ecosystem. So it includes our cloud services, Profi Cloud. It includes the PLCnext store, which is a marketplace for apps and complete solutions that you can download directly to a controller like this. It includes PLCnext Engineer, which is the software that you use to configure a device like this. And of course, it includes PLCnext Control. And PLCnext Control on a hardware platform like this, it means it's based on an open Linux operating system. It means that you can program this in traditional IEC 61131 languages, ladder logic, function block diagram. You can also produce deterministic real-time programs using C++ or C#, or even MATLAB Simulink. And all these applications can speak to each other seamlessly. So it really brings the security and reliability of a traditional PLC with the openness of the IT world.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So if I understood you wrong, I can program this controller in many different languages. I can use apps from the PLCnext store, and I can use also the PLCnext Engineer, right?
That's right. And with PLCnext Engineer, you don't just program the standard PLC, you can also program the safety PLC just with the one software development tool.
Wow, that's pretty cool. And you also said that this controller is very performant, so what makes it so powerful?
Well, on the standard side of the PLC, we have an Intel i5 dual core 2.4 gigahertz processor, which is very impressive for a PLC. And there's actually a second PLC inside this that implements the functional safety that has two ARM processors with different architectures. So that gives the diversity that we need to get the performance level for the functional safety applications.
Cool. That's very impressive. Like two brains working in one device. Where do you use such a controller?
Well, anywhere really that you need the highest performance from a standard PLC along with the functional safety applications. So things like process and chemical industries, things like automotive industry, materials handling and logistics. Wind farms is a big application. They do very complex calculations on their standard PLC, so this is perfect for that. And we've even done an application for a roller coaster.
A roller coaster, really?
That's right.
So this is an application where you definitely need safety. And this is already the next topic of the next question. So you already mentioned the two CPUs inside on the PACE safety PLC. What other safety functions does the PLC support?
So on the safety side, we can handle very large safety networks of up to 300 F devices. And we use ProfiSafe Profile version 2.6, which will handle all the latest safety devices and is very future-proof.
Cool. Safety is already the right keyword for you, Simon. So at Phoenix Contact, safety doesn't stop at the controller. What does Phoenix Contact offer for functional safety?
Yes, that's absolutely right. Alicia, of course, the controller is only a part of the complete concept, consisting of the controller itself. And you also need I/O, so input and output devices, in order to connect your safety sensors to and your actuators. And Phoenix Contact, we have quite a broad range of safety products now. So starting with a safety switch onto safety relays, configurable safety modules, high-performance PLCs, and last but not least, of course, our Axioline I.O. Range of products as well.
Okay, so a very convenient portfolio for the field and for the control cabinet. I think you also brought us a new product. What is that?
Yeah, here at the show, we're highlighting the latest addition to our portfolio. This is the Axioline IP67E device. It's an F device, as Martin mentioned earlier, so it's one of the 300 devices that we can address with our high power controller. It has M12 connectors, and there you can connect either 8 sensors or 2 channel sensors to. Sensors could be things like light curtains or perhaps an interlock switch or an e-stop. And it also has 4 safe outputs where we can switch off, for example, different types of actuators in the machine, including the motors. This is also a safety bridge technology device. That's a proprietary device technology that we have from Phoenix Contact. And ProfiSafe will also follow in the coming months.
Okay, sounds very good. Time's nearly over, so last question. Yeah. Simon, what do you think, where will functional safety go in the next years?
Yeah, it's a very good question. We are at the Hanover Messe this week. Digitalization is the buzzword, and of course safety has to keep pace with digitalization. So we see two sort of trends at the moment. One is we think devices will become more intelligent, so they become smarter. That means that safety devices from a low-level device will be connected to and integrated into networks. That's one trend. I think another thing is the standardization of safety protocols. So if we look at machine communication like OPC UA, where ProfiSafe will be the harmonized protocol at the PLC level. And if we look at the lower level with IO-Link safety, then we have much more standardization to look forward to in the future. The advantage for the customer would be in handling and, of course, the total cost of ownership for the safety solution in his machine.
Okay, so thank you for this overview. Thanks to you as well. It was a pleasure with you. And if you want to know more about our products, visit us here in Hall 9 on our booth of Phoenix Contact or watch our YouTube live stream. So don't forget to subscribe on YouTube. And I hope I'll see you tomorrow for the next live stream about PLCnext Store. Thank you. Bye.
That's fine.
So.
Yeah.